Welcome to the Heidi Thorne Show. I'm your host, Heidi Thorne, and in this podcast, I share my real-world self-publishing and small business experience with you. So let's get started with today's show. Now, I am in the process of publishing my new book, Networking for Authors, and it's going to be both on Kindle and Audible. And so that is coming out very shortly, and the opportunity that it allowed me was to try out Kindle Create again and see what updates have been made to that tool. For those of you that don't remember, Kindle Create is the formatting tool that Kindle Direct Publishing now offers, and it has a lot of automatic formatting features, which are fantastic. And so I was really glad to have the opportunity to check it out again, because it's been some months since I actually had to use it for a book. And so I am glad to announce that there have been some updates. And it was funny because I'm putting together my Kindle book, and as I was opening Kindle Create, of course, it updated the software, but even as I was working with it, it says, hey, there's another update. I'm so glad to see that this is coming. So there are a lot of exciting new features, and I will review some of those today. And for those of you that are just listening on audio, you're going to hear about some of these new features, but I would encourage you to go over and see the YouTube video of this podcast episode. Let's go through some of these new features. Now, here are some important points for the latest Kindle Create version, which is the early 2020 update. The front and back matter are created through form fill elements, so you don't have to include them in your manuscript file. In fact, you actually shouldn't. Your manuscript file should be the chapters only. Now, this applies only for Kindle Create. If you're just uploading your manuscript directly to Kindle Direct Publishing, you have to have the full manuscript. But if you are using this Kindle Create tool, just do the chapters only. I found this out the hard way. And Kindle Create identifies the chapters, and then what it does is it puts them into the body of the book. In the contents pane, you're going to click the plus sign, and you'll get access to these elements. Now, the following elements are form fill or they're automated. Now, form fill, what I mean is there's a blank, you just enter the information, and it automatically formats the page for you. The title page, the copyright page, the dedication, the epigraph, and your table of contents will be auto-generated. If you click on the table of contents, it scans your file and it will auto-generate the TOC for you. Now, for the next group of front matter elements, you can type them in directly into the page that appears. It's a blank page, or you can copy and paste text. You may have done it in a Word file or some other text-based file, and you can just copy and paste it from there instead of typing it directly in. The preface, introduction, prologue, foreword, and then they offer you a blank page, a standard page. If it doesn't fit into any of these categories here and you want some sort of custom page in your front matter, you can do that directly in the front matter elements section. Now, the chapters or the body of your book is in that center section of the contents pane, and you can click the plus sign to add a couple of elements. Now, this one is a form fill or automated one, and that is the part page. Now, this is not required, but if you have your book broken up into sections, this is very common in like nonfiction, where you have part one, part two, part three, you can enter the part pages here. It will put them exactly where you want them. You can drag them to the proper place if they didn't get in the right place the first time. And you can just type in the text that you want on that title page, and it will format it correctly for that section. Now, this is a type in or copy and paste for a chapter page. Let's say after you've uploaded the manuscript, you think, oh, geez, I would have liked to add another chapter to that. You can do it directly in Kindle Create with the chapter page. Now, the back matter performs very similarly to the front matter elements. And there are some form fill or automated ones that you can choose from. And it would be books by this author, about the author, books in this series, praise for the author. Again, you just type in the text in the boxes and it will format the page automatically for you. Now, these are more custom pages. You can either type it directly in that page or you can copy and paste text from some other program. Epilogue, afterword, acknowledgement, and a standard page if you have some other special kind of resource that you want to put at the back of your book. Now, the chapters in front and back matter elements can be rearranged by drag and drop within their section, but you can't move it to another section. So for example, you cannot move something from the chapters to the front matter. Now, I had a problem with this because I usually do an introduction chapter, and so I had uploaded it with my manuscript file, and then I tried to move the introduction to the front matter, and it wouldn't allow me to do that. Now, your text in the manuscript file should include chapter plus the number of the chapter and any title text you have. And I would suggest inserting a section break between each chapter, not just a page break. It doesn't work that way. What I had done is I had done kind of like a string of my text, chapter after chapter after chapter, and it didn't quite identify all of them correctly. So I would suggest putting a section break in there. Now, Kindle Create can create a table of contents with clickable links automatically, and that's for the Kindle version. It's the easiest thing ever. You don't have to mess with it. You don't have to create the links. You don't anything. It just does it for you automatically. Now, the Kindle Create print side of the equation for the program, again, you're creating one file that will be for both the print and ebook version. However, there's some little extra things you have to pay attention to with the print side of the equation. Now, it offers choices for the header and footer styles, and then it automatically formats all your pages through the entire book according to that style. It's currently under an icon that says print settings, and we used to not have any choice in terms of the header and footer. It just did one. Now I think there's about eight. So you can choose from having it mirrored on the right and left for page numbers or headers, or you can have the page number and the header all on the top. There's eight different ones, so choose one that looks the best for your book, and then what it does it automatically. Now, if any of you have worked with Microsoft Word and the headers and footers, it is the most annoying thing ever because nothing ever works just perfectly. And I will tell you that this works perfectly. And it automatically adds the page numbers. In addition to creating the table of contents, which it does for the ebook version too, on the print side of the equation, it adds the page numbers and it automatically puts them in your table of contents. It's so easy. So I'm just in love with this program. Now, it isn't without issues on the print side of Kindle Create. There's still no hyphenation control. There's no line break control, no widow and orphan control. Now, widows and orphans are a single word that's left at the end of a paragraph or at the top of a page. Now, it should be squeezed into the paragraph that it's a part of, so that you have nice, even lines for easy reading for your readers. And it just looks very ragged the other way. So there's really no way you can do that. And with the hyphenation, it's even worse because it'll put like parts of words on a line by itself. Ugh, so they still have a lot of work to do here. And there's no page break control. This is really problematic if you have like subheaders. I have them in my books because they're nonfiction and there's sections within each chapter. And sometimes it will put the subheader at the bottom of the page and then there's no paragraph underneath it. It's just the subheader. That's not standard book formatting. So there's no page break control yet. And you still may have to do some paragraph formatting. It will do some really basic formatting of your text. But what I found is that I had to make sure that all the indents for the paragraphs were good. And it depends on what styling you want. So you still may have to do quite a bit of paragraph formatting once the document is in Kindle Create. So do check through the entire document once it's uploaded, even though it will do a lot of things automatically. And the other thing is that there's no print preview in Kindle Create. You can only get this through KDP when you upload the KPF file. I'm hoping that one day it will be within the Kindle Create program itself. So I'm hoping that will change in the future, but right now there's no print preview. Those of you who haven't gotten started yet with publishing a Kindle ebook, I do have a Udemy course on how to self-publish a nonfiction Kindle ebook like a pro. So you'll definitely want to check that out with more information on Kindle publishing, more than just the formatting, but just a lot of other information that you'll need to get your Kindle book going. I hope you have found all of this helpful, and if you have, I would really appreciate it if you would rate, review, and subscribe to The Heidi Thorne Show. I am on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Stitcher, Podbean, and you can subscribe there. And if you like to listen on your Alexa, you just have to use the Apple Podcast skill, and you can get my podcast on your Alexa that way. For those of you that like to watch the video or just listen to the video on YouTube, and for those of you that have been listening on audio, you might want to check out today's podcast episode on the YouTube video. You just have to go to my Heidi Thorne YouTube channel, and I do have the Heidi Thorne Show playlist, which you can go to, and you can look at all those videos there. But when you're on the channel, subscribe and also hit the notifications settings. I think it's the little bell icon, and choose to get a notification so that you'll know when new videos are available. I would also appreciate it if you would share The Heidi Thorne Show with your friends on social media. Now, if you'd like to check out my self-published books, they are on Amazon, Audible, and Apple Books. All you have to do is go to my Heidi Thorne author page, and all the books that are available are shown on that page. If you'd like to connect with me, my website is very simply HeidiThorne.com. Thank you so much for listening and for your support. I'll look forward to talking with you again in the next episode. And in the meantime, have a great day.